You know what is the Catholic's farewell message? Pray for me. Correct, no? Wherever you go, I find this. I preach retreats, you know, and they come to thank me. Brother, thank you very much for the retreat. It was good, la, 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 la. And then they will slip this. Pray for me. Can you pray for 1,000 people? And I want to tell you also the truth, how people will do this. They will pray for you surely once, and then they will forget you. Nobody will pray for you for life. Nobody. I became very smart, you know, at my retreats, you know. When people stand in the line, thank you, thank you, thank you, before they can say anything, I say, pray for me. They are so disappointed. You must see the expression on their face. You pray to the Holy Spirit. He is the intercessor. He is an intercessor. Pray to the Holy Spirit, and he will pray for and on behalf of you. Amazing. And you will see your prayers getting a breakthrough in your life. John 14 verse 16. I will ask the Father, and he will give you another comforter. He will remain with you forever. The Holy Spirit will bring life, life. He'll infuse life to you in your marriage, in your life. There will be a new meaning for you to live for your spouse, to live for your children, because this is done through the power of the Holy Spirit. That's the power of the Holy Spirit. Yeah? He'll bring passion into your marriage. How many people have lost passion and romance in their marriage? That fellow. Finished. Gone. No spark. Yeah, no spark. Spark all went long back. You see, it's your marriage. Who can help you? You. No one else can help you. They can only give you advice. If you go to a counselor, he'll only give you advice. But who can bring a spark? Who can bring passion? Who can bring romance into your marriage? You. So make time for your spouse. Make time for your spouse. Spend some time with your spouse. It'll ignite passion into your marriage. Yeah. Live for your marriage, you know. Help. Yeah, the Holy Spirit will help you to live for your marriage. Yeah, the Holy Spirit will help you to be open and to accept suggestions. Don't tell, oh, this is how I live. This is how it is me. No, don't do that. Wherever the Holy Spirit is, he will make you open. Ability to accept changes in self and spouse, the Holy Spirit will do that. Romans 8 verse 11 says, the Spirit of God who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you. And just as God raised Christ Jesus from the dead, he will give life to your mortal bodies by the same Spirit that is living in you. The Holy Spirit will bring life to you. He'll bring life to your marriage. When your faith is strong, you never give up. You keep praying. Pray for your body. Pray for your body. Because the Holy Spirit will bring healing to your body. That's what the Holy Spirit will do. Don't misunderstand me. I'm not saying don't go to a doctor. Yeah, but I'm not saying that. But I make sure I do this. I go first to the greatest physician, that is Jesus. And then if it doesn't work, which normally works, you see, go. Learn to pray for your body. Why the Holy Spirit is in you? Let me share very quickly something to you. You know, once 5 years back, I went to for my medical checkup, and the doctor examined my life, and the doctor told me, you know, Colin, you have high blood pressure. I am forced to put you on a medication. So he put me on a medication. Every morning, I have to take a tablet. Every morning. And you know how these tablets work? In the sense, if you forget to take one day, fear will hit you. Fear will come. Fear is the cause of all our problems. Fear is the cause of all our illnesses. So you must learn. So you see, the Holy Spirit will give that ability to become more positive in life, not negative. How many people are negative? What causes our illness? We are so negative. We are like false prophets. I asked some aunties in Bangalore, auntie, how are you? Not well, my son. See that?
How are you, auntie? 3 months later, not well, my son. 3 months later, auntie, how are you? Not well, my son. Where are they? In the well. Because that's what they're saying. I'm not well. If you keep on saying I'm not well, I'm no good, I'm failure, I'm disappointed, that's where you'll remain. Because the word of God says in Proverbs chapter 18, 21. Write down. Paste it somewhere in your house. Proverbs 18, 21. Death and life is in the power of the tongue. Death and life is in the power of the tongue. What you say will happen. So you must be very, very careful what you say. Speak positively. Don't speak negatively. Yeah. Be positive. So one day, I read this scripture. I discovered it. And so one day, I know I've been on this tablets for 5 years. One day I got up from my bed and I made a prayer like this. This is what I did. I'll tell you. If you're suffering from diabetics, if you're suffering from blood pressure, do this in the name of Jesus and you'll get healed. I made a simple prayer. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command my blood pressure to become normal. I prayed in tongues. You know what is praying in tongues? Hello? Do you have the gift of tongues? How many of you have the gift of tongues? I just want to, okay. Try and get it, huh? Others, I really wish I could stay back and give you one talk on that, yeah? But I have to go. But let me tell you, you see the gift of tongues, and I prayed in tongues. I prayed in tongues for 2 minutes. You know what happened to my body? In 24 hours, my blood pressure became normal. Say hallelujah. It is 3.5 years now. I have not taken a single tablet. Completely healed. Say hallelujah. 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 That's how it is. The Holy Spirit is in you. He will bring healing to your life. Whatever you are struggling from. Yeah. That's how I deal with my body like that. If I have a stomach upset, the other day, I was in the Philippines. I go to every year to the Philippines, you know, to preach to a community in Philippines. I went to Philippines and it's an eight from Manila, which is the capital of the Philippines. It's an 8-hour bus drive and I finished the program Sunday evening and I caught a stomach bug. Never easy to get on a bus, 8-hour journey with a stomach bug. I commanded my stomach. I said, in the name of Jesus Christ, I command my stomach will function normally. Prayed in tongues. Got on the bus. No problem. Take authority. That's how it is. Death and life is in the power of the tongue. The power of the Holy Spirit. He'll take control. He's God. He's God. He'll do it for your life. But you learn to do it. Please learn to do it. Then only you will live a victorious life. You will be a victor and you will not be a victim. Many people are living victims today. Be a victorious life. I live like that. That's what we do for our son. You know, I gave this scripture, Romans chapter 8, verse 11. That is what we are praying in our son's life for 18 years. We were in Germany when the doctor did an MRI scan on my son. My son was 14 months then and we had no clue that our son had suffered a brain damage. And the German doctors did this MRI scan and they came to us and told us, extensive brain damage, irreversible. That's what they told. Irreversible. We can do nothing. Sorry. The same German doctors told us, your son will be a vegetable all his life. Your son will die before the age of 28. They told us. We didn't accept it. We canceled it in the name of Jesus. And we prayed the word of God into his life. every day. My wife prays 40 scriptures, 40 every day into the life of Michael, my son. He is just growing and becoming perfect. 90% healed. 10 more percent. Hey. That's God. That is what it means to live the Christian life. Not to live this defeated life. I cannot do anything. What can I do? I have this pain. We are too much of pain. No, Catholics have. Have you noticed it? Catholics suffer from all this joint pain. How many people tell me, brother, my joint is paining. This joint is paining. This joint is paining. This joint is paining. One day I told God, God, you should have made Catholics without joints. Never ending, right? You know why never ending? Because you don't know how to pray. If you pray the way, what I'm trying to tell you, death and life is in the power of the tongue. If you're positive, you speak to your body, you speak to situations, you speak to circumstances, you can speak to the weather. It will obey you. Jesus spoke to the storm, remember? Hello, are you there? Remember the scene? Jesus spoke to the storm, he calmed the storm, and then he told the disciples, "Oh, you of little faith." Why he said, "Oh, you of little faith"? Because the disciples could have done it. They didn't do it. They didn't do it. That's why he's saying, "Hey, little faith, you could have commanded the storm to stop. It will obey you." God has given you and me that authority. Genesis chapter 1:26. In Genesis chapter 1:26, God has given you and me the authority. You know what Genesis 1:26 says? God made us man and woman in his likeness and image. And then it comes here. Made us in his likeness and image. Why? So that we can rule. Dominion over everything. You have the power. God has given you the authority. Don't keep on telling people, "I am sick, I am sick." You will be there, I'm telling you. Become positive. Become more and more positive. Everything will work for you. Yeah. Everything will work for you. I take my son, whenever I'm in Bangalore, I travel, but whenever I'm in Bangalore, I take my son for physiotherapy. It's a 1 hour session. So I take my son for physiotherapy and I wait till it's over and I bring him back home. There is another guy. His name is Kedar. He brings his son who is suffering from autism, also for physiotherapy, and occasionally we meet and we drink a cup of tea. And every time Kedar meets me, this is what he tells me. Same record. You know what he tells? "Sir, my boss is horrible. I am in the same process for 11 years. I have not got a promotion for 9 years. My colleagues are terrible. Complain, complain, complain." You see that? One day I told this guy, I said, "Kedar, you must change your speech." The minute I told him, "You must change your speech," this guy, you know, he sat up straight. He said, "Sir, what did you tell?" I said, "Change your speech, Kedar. It will change your life." "How should I? What should I do, sir?" I said, "Hey, Kedar, every morning," he's a non-Christian, right? "Every morning you get up and say, 'I will be an excellent workman. My boss will be the best boss in the world. I will be successful. I will be prosperous. I will love my job. I will get a promotion. My work will change.'" Whatever. "What you want to see, declare it," I told him. His face lit up. He said, "Nobody has told me this." I said, "Yeah, very good. I'm telling you, go." 2 days later, you know what happened? I dropped my son at physiotherapy and I was sitting in the car reading something and I saw Kedar pass me. He didn't see me. What a change. You know, this guy is walking like this, as if the whole of Bangalore belongs to him. earlier, like this, always hunched. Sir, how are you, sir? You see, when you're negative, it will affect your posture. When you're positive, your posture also changes. First time I saw this guy, you know, wearing formal pant. You see, it changes entire outlook. Otherwise, only the jeans. Thank God for jeans, right? Even 3 years, you don't have to wash it. Whoever manufactured it, thank God. Clean shaven. Then he saw me sitting in the car and he came running to me, this guy. And he told me, sir, the last 2 days have been the best days in my life. I said, Kedar, what did you do? Sir, I'm getting up every morning declaring. Everything is changing, sir. People at work are changing. Colleagues are becoming better. Yesterday morning, sir, my boss smiled. The power of positive confession. That's how the word of God is. Take the word of God, apply it. It will bring life to you. And that's why the Holy Spirit will bring life to your body. Life. In any situation. Any situation. Don't say, I'm a failure. If you keep saying I'm a failure, you will remain a failure. Nobody can help you. All of us know this story. Remember in Matthew chapter 17, Jesus is telling all his disciples, if you have faith like a mustard seed, remember that story? You can say to a mountain, you can speak to the mountain. If you say to the mountain, be moved, it will move. Wow. What is your mountain, sisters and brothers? Are you facing a mountain in your marriage? Finances? Is it health? Is it your children? Is it their mother-in-law? Yeah. Speak to the mountain. Speak to whatever it is, the finance, your health, issues in life. Speak to it. Jesus said, speak to the mountain, it will move. If you speak to the mountain, nothing is impossible for you, said Jesus. End of the statement. Speak to the mountain. You know what mistake we do? We take the mountain to God. Don't take the mountain to God. Jesus has given you the ability through the power of the Holy Spirit to speak and it will move. Amen? Say hallelujah. Do this. You will be amazed how it will work in your life. Because God has made us and given us power and authority. Once I was in Colombo, Sri Lanka, preaching to the leaders in Colombo. And we were, evening, two of my friends were walking on the streets of Colombo. And my friends told me, you know, Colin, this is the best ice cream parlor in Colombo. Best ice cream. And, you know, I don't eat ice cream. When I'm on mission, with this thought, it will affect my throat. So immediately I thought, another 5 more days in Colombo, no ice cream. I didn't tell them. Immediately the Holy Spirit, see, when you develop a relationship with the Holy Spirit, He will start speaking to you. He will tell you what to do. The Holy Spirit told me, don't become a slave to an ice cream. Command it. Speak to it. So in my mind, I said, in the name of Jesus Christ, I command no ice cream ever will affect my throat anymore. And I had a double scoop. I want to tell you, nothing happened. I preached that entire mission. Nothing happened because I took control over it. I spoke life into it. I commanded it to leave me. Now wherever I go on mission, anywhere I go on mission, I have ice cream. If you invite me this afternoon, I will come. Yesterday afternoon somebody invited me, I had ice cream, nothing happened. Why? Gone. We are so caught. You know, sisters and brothers, in closing I want to tell you,
Be careful of superstition. You are a Catholic.
There is no room for superstition in your life. You trust God. Don't have this old mother's some stories. And we are filled with it in India. I don't know why. Some people tell, don't eat cucumber. It is cooling. Have you noticed it? Can you imagine cucumber controlling your life? Unbelievable. Don't eat papaya. It is heaty. Papaya. Buy a few and go home. We are bound by this superstition. All superstition. Be careful of a lime on a street. In India, full of limes only. Where to go? You know what Jesus said? You know what Jesus said? You know, we should know the word of God. You know what Jesus said in Mark chapter 16? You can drink poison. It will not harm you. You can drink poison. It will not harm you. If you know that the Holy Spirit is in control of your life, nothing will harm you. Impossible to touch you. You know what Jesus said? You can pick up a serpent. It will not harm you. How many of you know Psalm 91? All Catholics under the sun know Psalm 91. Nobody puts and believes it. You know what Psalm 91 verse 7 says? What does Psalm 91 verse 7 says, sisters and brothers? Hello? 1,000 may fall to your left. 10,000 may fall to your right. No harm. No harm will come to you. You believe it? You believe it? Declare it. No harm will touch you. No harm will touch your family. No harm will touch your children. No harm will touch you. Nothing, nothing can happen to you. You know what Psalm 91 verse 10 says? No evil will come to your camp. No evil can touch your household. You know that? Amen? Say hallelujah. Live like that. And who can make this alive for us? Holy Spirit. Yeah? I want to give you, I got two more minutes. I want to give you three lines. How to have a relationship with the Holy Spirit. Line number one, Holy Spirit, I love you. Line number two, Holy Spirit, be my helper. Line number three, Holy Spirit, take control of my life. Three lines, if you say it every day. What is it? Holy Spirit, I love you. Holy Spirit, be my helper. Holy Spirit, take control of my life. I prayed, believe me. I prayed around 20, 40 times a day to become aware God is in me. Greater is in me. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world, says 1 John chapter 4 verse 4. Every day say, Holy Spirit, I love you. Holy Spirit, be my helper. Holy Spirit, take control of my life. The Holy Spirit will become more and more and more active in your life. He'll take control of your life. And will put you on the right path of God. Amen. That's what he does. Yeah. So before we close, just stand. Take both your hands, sisters and brothers. Close your eyes. Put it on your heart. The Bible says, God is in you. He's not outside you. God is in you. Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. God dwells within you, says Romans chapter 8 verse 9. God is in you. Become aware of that. The Holy Spirit is in you. And start praying to the Holy Spirit. He is God. The minute you pray, the minute you connect, he will respond to you. And he'll become very active in your life. You'll be amazed what the Holy Spirit can do for you. And as you put your hand on your heart, say this, all of you. Holy Spirit, I love you. Holy Spirit, be my helper. Holy Spirit, take control of my life. Holy Spirit, I love you. Holy Spirit, be my helper. Holy Spirit, take control of my life. Now in the silence of your heart, you pray to the Holy Spirit. These three lines. Holy Spirit, I love you. Holy Spirit, be my helper. Holy Spirit, take control of my life. Softly, softly. Connect with the Holy Spirit. In your free time, connect with the Holy Spirit. When you go to the chapel, connect with the Holy Spirit right through this retreat. You will just be amazed what the Holy Spirit will do in your life, because he will become more active and will start working in your life. And you will experience life. Life in your individual lives. Life in your marriage. Life to your children. Let's raise our hands to Jesus. Let's praise him. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, 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 Lord. Praise your holy name, Lord. May your name be praised, Lord. God amana shanda manana 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 manana. Dena mana shanda manana 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 manana. Good amana shanda manana manana. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Raise your hands and just worship. Worship the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You are my comforter. You are my helper. You are my advocate. You are my intercessor. Go namana shanna manana 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 mani. Go namana shanna manana 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 mani. Diravara shanna manana 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 mani. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Bless your name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. In the name of the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. Amen.